I want to get a good sense from folks that study the data. And that's why we're thrilled to have Miro Copic on. He is an analyst in these issues, and we've had him on the show before. Miro, thanks so much for stopping by.
Thanks, Carl. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving. So let's talk first and foremost about Black Friday generically. Is it waning in importance with the advent of things like Cyber Monday?
No. You know, a little bit, because what retailers have done is they've kind of made Black Friday the entire month of November, but still over $90 billion is going to be transacted this weekend from Black Friday through Cyber Monday, but only $8 billion of that is going to be on Cyber Monday. So Cyber Monday still is dwarfed by Black Friday, Small Business Saturday. And a lot of consumers, you know, they actually start shopping, you know, for Black Friday on Thursday night. So what retailers have done, there's a lot of people, about 40% of consumers, really cherish starting their morning at 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock on Black Friday, and that's a rite of passage and a tradition for their family. But the rest of consumers, retailers realize that's a pretty harrowing thing, and by expanding and opening on Thursday and making sure that all those doorbuster specials are available regardless, it's made people less stressed and are willing to kind of go out this weekend.
Okay, so we've seen major bankruptcies announced for like Sears and Kmart, same company, and other companies like Macy's have significantly cut back on their stores, while Amazon continues to just spread its tentacles into almost everything. Are we seeing a shift away from those traditional brick-and-mortar stores?
Well, certain stores have done really well. For example, Best Buy has really kind of faced Amazon pretty nicely. They've kind of revamped their business. A lot of specialty stores are doing really well. Still 80%, over 80% of spending this holiday season and last holiday season is going to be done in a store. And what stores have done is they've improved their online shopping experience to offset Amazon. They allow people to buy a product and pick it up in store, and when consumers go in store, they impulse buy a lot more than they do online. And so while most consumers actually start their shopping online and they use it to kind of evaluate options, they still go in the store. And this season, this weekend, over 160 million consumers are going to be out in the malls.
160 million.
Yeah.
That's half of the country, and some of those, some of the other half of the country are in nursing homes or in daycare centers.
Exactly. You know, again, there's some duplication there, but it really is. Malls have done a great job here in San Diego, for example, whether it's, say, Fashion Valley or recently the revamped UTC. They've done a great job to support retailers by creating a better experience at the mall, better restaurants, there's movies, there's different things to do. So people can go to a destination like the mall, enjoy other things there, and then go do at retail. And that really does help retailers because it makes malls much more of a destination. And malls across the country are making some of this shift, especially the A and B level malls.
Like, for example, Horton Plaza basically is shifting to office space, a little cluster, you know, work environment, rather than emphasizing retail stores. And they basically lost all their retail stores of any merit, and the homeless basically took it over. Would you say that that's just because there wasn't a solid strategy for that location in particular, and that other malls like the revamped UTC have been able to reinvent themselves?
You know, and yes, you know, whether it's Westfield or Simon, those mall development companies are really looking at the mall in a different way, and they do reinvent themselves. But UTC, for even UTC, the new UTC is going to have a fair amount of office space, but it's still going to have a fair amount of retail space, and they're going to kind of coexist. The problem with UTC or with Horton Plaza was that it was very closed as a mall. When it was first built, it was the place to go in downtown San Diego, but with, you know, all the gas lamp and everything moving east, it became less relevant. And the malls like Fashion Valley, to an extent Mission Valley and UTC, are big destination locations for San Diegans.
All right, Miro Copic, thanks so much. San Diego State University lecturer.